You are welcome. We have a little energy, so there's time to talk. And the most important thing you need to know is information on the incident. And I'm not talking about a cyber attack and crazy robots. Everything is clear about that, it was in all the news. The incident is what I call, what happened after. I watched a flash of bright light swallow the whole planet. This light reached me. After that, the broadcast ceased, and all the station personnel died for no apparent reason. It was like a weapon of mass destruction. But such a powerful and deadly weapon has never existed. Therefore, one of our main tasks is to find out what kind of device caused this, and neutralize it. I can't move into the body of the robot because these shells don't have enough internal resources to house a neural network of my complexity. Therefore, I need you. I can't force you to do anything. Of course, you are free to sit here and wait for your body to recover, and then spend a long and boring life locked up, eating protein mucus. Or you can help me figure it out. You've got to admit, we make a great team. It will be fun. If you agree to help, go to the control room. I will give you access. Great. I knew I could count on you, partner. This is our planet. Most of the infrastructure on its surface looks lifeless. But some complexes are still functioning. In those complexes, I've recorded increased shell activity. But not all of them are aggressive and crazy. Some shells have grouped together and work as a team. Most likely, they are controlled by the surviving colonists. But for reasons unknown to me, these groups are fighting not only with infected robots, but also with each other. So it's not worth counting on hospitality. In any case, you need some kind of protection. I can't break combat shells. They have a powerful firewall. Therefore, we will use the familiar models of the engineering core, with a technical tool. The tool, of course, is not a weapon, but I will try to adjust it to a stressful mode of operation. When overloaded, the arc of the spark gap and the welding beam cause significant damage. A nail gun shoots nails over long distances. But that's all in theory. How about some practice? Should we start? Go to the control panel. Here we will plan all operations, choosing objects on the planet's surface and those available to hack shells. All the information about upcoming missions you will find here. Also here you will be able to find collected data about your enemies and events of the cataclysm period. You can make upgrades and change settings right from here. Now, let's get to work. You should know, the shells always have two tools. I hack them so that the tool from the blue slot is effective for long-range combat, and from red for the close. Remember this. The tools were hacked hastily. They're unstable. But the algorithm can be improved, allowing for the creation of new firmware. I will analyze the operation of devices at the time of their successful implementation and improve the settings as I'm able. Simply put, the more enemies you kill with a particular tool, the better the outcome will be. Let's try testing the hacked tools with something more useful. Find the energy at the center of this platform, and empty it. The enemy goes for hand-to-hand combat. Use melee weapons, from the red slot. Be aware, weapons from the red slot takes the enemy off balance, and do more damage, but are limited in range. Shooters ahead. Use ranged weapons from the blue slot against them. I think you'll figure out what to do next. Alternate melee and ranged weapons depending on the situation. This lever removes the energy barrier. Use it. The lever is locked by a security system. There should be an access terminal. Find it. It will look like a stand with a small screen. Once completed, return to the lever. The levers, buttons, and terminals are the same throughout the planet. They are standardized for the interaction algorithm of shells. Look for them to unlock access to blocked areas. Pay attention, the shells of the engineering core are equipped with an augmented reality interface. Above the objects available for interaction, you will see the corresponding hologram. cavalry has arrived. Watch out for the big guy. Everything is clear. There will be no more guests. These were virus-infected shells. Such robots do not make contact. I studied a similar instance at the station after I eliminated it. Its primary directive is the search and destruction of everything that the friend or foe system does not recognize. Well, that's it. We just need to obtain the energy and leave. Great. Energy transfer completed. Bringing you back to the station. Continue sorties and improve battle tactics. Look for any information you can find and get us energy. In the meantime, I will draw up a plan for further action. Besides the energy from the last energy storage, I extracted the crypto matrix. With its help, it is possible to improve the algorithm of hacking and better reveal the potential of shells. You can use obtained crypto matrixes in the enhancements menu on the left-hand side of the screen. Sometimes we will have access to objectives with additional bonuses. You will find them on the left and right from the main mission. For example, I have now found an object with valuable information that will help you expand your arsenal of tools. I scanned its power grid and found a technical database. This is an archive of serial numbers and authorization codes for the shells that are inaccessible to us. Download the archive and I will be able to crack robots with a new tool. It's time to get a new tool. Get to the power hub and download its database. Done. It's time to get out of here. We have a new tool. I have already prepared a firmware for it extreme mode of work. Try its stability. Bingo. Total jackpot. An analysis of the protocols indicates that the facility was preparing for demolition, and all the shells here are from the dismantling team. They are equipped with stripping cutters that can be used as powerful melee weapons. These power blades freely destroy the matter, ignoring any possible protection. Try them. To activate the stripping cutter, hold the trigger and press grip. The cutter will be active as long as the trigger is held. Try to destroy de-energized shells. The power consumption of cutters is incredibly high. To keep enough energy until the end of the mission, I will set the blades so that the maximum energy consumption and the effect of the splitting of matter will be active only when in contact with the enemy. Crushing everything is too expensive. Unfortunately, the initialization code for stripping cutters cannot be cracked. If you want to get them into your arsenal, go to the energy center. Use the authorization protocol for this shell to access the dismantling tool warehouse. Thank you. Great. I got access to the dismantling tool warehouse. Now all of our shells will be equipped with stripping cutters. The job is done. The tool is ours. Go to the console, try out the new shell in the next mission. Here is another energy hub with a technical archive. It will not be difficult to get it. And we will have a new tool at our disposal. It's done. Target met. All right, the database is ours. These archives were installed by the foreman of the teams at the repair sites. They facilitated access to storage resources. The database was always erased at the end of the process, but the incident left many cases unfinished.